For the bank to grow, additional capital injection was required. So out of this, there was a rights issue that I think every time, I think even when we met last year, we were still asking about whether the rights issue is going to happen. Where are we with the rights issue?
The rights issue, as I said, 2013 AGM, the shareholders approved it. 2014, at the beginning of the year, we put through transactional advisors our prospectus, yeah, which goes to the CMA. By April, we had the final CMA ready and filed with the CMA. Our objective was by 1st July we get the capital, 2014. That hasn't happened to date because the CMA awaits the principal shareholders to confirm that they will take up. And NSF has already confirmed. Treasury has a couple of times actually put in the budget from what I've seen. And they are competing priorities at Treasury level. But that's where it is at the moment. CMA approval is what we are waiting. And we in the meantime, have to manage the business with whatever capital we have and whatever we can generate organically. What that does is essentially the business growth rate will not be at that accelerated pace as it would be if we had the full capital, because we're now generating our own capital internally. It takes a little bit longer. We've also done a bit of boosting that capital, shoring it up as we await the approval from Treasury and CMA. That shoring up we're doing is primarily with last year not paid dividends. We retained the entire profits. The second item we said is we will sell the suboptimal assets, meaning branch and some houses that the bank owns, and use that to boost the capital as we await the big capital injection. So that would give us a bit of life up to the end of the year, up to probably Q1 next year. But we will obviously, for us to grow at a higher pace, will require that capital injection. And why not? All the other banks that we compete with have actually in 2014 raised plenty of capital, over 70 billion roughly.
So if the rights issue doesn't come through, is it the only way you can raise the capital, or even thinking going the route through a bond, or is it the only concrete plan that you've put on the table so far?
We can consider bonds, but bonds will not do for us. What we're looking for is core capital.
Yeah.
The bonds, subordinated debt, all those will be essentially tier two capital. Tier two capital is not our main pain point. Our main point is core capital. So that's the constraining factor that we need addressed. And the bonds, therefore, are a supplementary capital that we can raise at any point in time.
Yeah.
And again, you go for the big capital injection. If we get the core capital, that addresses the whole capital requirement. So there's no need to address just something that will not actually cure your need for capital.
Your short-term problem.
And you spend a lot more resources raising a supplementary capital while you still have got a gap on your core capital.